One of the busiest traveling weeks of the year is upon us. The Transportation Security Administration expects to see a major increase in those who travel via air. Our Tristan Lewis joins us now with tips on what to expect for those who plan on taking a flight this next week. Tristan.
Shira, in 2019, the Boise Airport saw 4.1 million passengers travel through that airport. This year, they're not on the same track of that year because of getting off to a slow start by the pandemic, but expectations are still high after a record summer. They had 420,000 passengers travel in July just alone. They expect to see this fall rival the same numbers they saw in 2019's fall. Thanksgiving is upon us, which marks one of the busiest travel weeks in the country. TSA expects 20 million people to come through security checkpoints across the U.S. this next week. And over at the Boise Airport, they're expecting to see near pre-pandemic levels of traffic.
This year, we fully expect the passenger traffic to be on par with what we saw in 2019, which was a record year for the Boise Airport. And on those peak days, we expect up to 14,000 passengers flying in and flying out per day.
The peak days next week will be Tuesday and Wednesday, right before the Thanksgiving holiday, and that's Sunday and Monday after the holiday.
Number one piece of advice is arrive early.
Boise Airport advises travelers to give themselves at least 2 hours prior to the departure time. It'll give passengers enough time to find parking, which Boise Airport expects to be full this next week, check in, get through security, and find their terminal. And speaking of security, TSA says they'll be fully staffed next week at the Boise Airport, so hopefully travelers won't deal with too many holdups.
We're going to extend the shifts of our officers to make sure that we can keep all the lanes open based on the number of people we project will be coming to the checkpoint.
TSA also expects to see a lot more food coming through the gates this year, too. So they're advising people to know what can go through security and what can't.
If you can spread it or spray it, pump it or pour it, it's considered a liquid. If it is a liquid, then what you need to know is that it needs to be under 3.4 ounces or 100 milliliters or less to go in your carry-on luggage. Otherwise, you need to pack that to put it in your checked baggage.
Items that are allowed in unlimited quantities are breads, meats, and vegetables. If someone needs to keep their food cold, ice packs are okay, but need to be frozen solid and not melted as they go through security. And TSA says they are working to implement the federal employee vaccine requirement that's set for November 22nd, but they do not anticipate the vaccine mandate will impact their ability to staff for Thanksgiving travel. Shira.
Good information there. And Tristan, you talked about food. I know some folks might be wondering, well, what about that pumpkin pie if that's allowed through security? What'd they say?
Yeah, sure. That actually falls under bread. So I was surprised to find out you can bring on pies, you can bring casseroles, you can even bring mac and cheese all through the airport security.
Good information there. Thank you.